What's up guys, in this tutorial, I will show you how to play Genshin Impact Mobile on your Windows PC or Mac using a PlayStation or Xbox controller. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. To play Genshin Impact Mobile on your PC, you must use an Android emulator such as BlueStacks. BlueStacks is a popular choice to play mobile games on your PC, as it's optimized for playing mobile games. Click on the first link in the description to get to this page. From here, download the BlueStacks 5 setup installer to your system. This should take a second to complete, and you can follow the install wizard to install the application to your system. After the installation is complete, BlueStacks should open up automatically. Next, open your Play Store and ensure you're logged in with your Google account. Search for Genshin Impact Mobile and download the game to your BlueStacks emulator. This might take a few minutes to complete, depending on your network connection. While downloading the game, you should take a look at your emulator settings. Click on this gear icon to access these settings. In the Gamepad section, enable the Gamepad Detection option. This will allow BlueStacks to recognize and receive input from your controller. Below, set the gamepad input settings to automatic, and set the gamepad vibration option to your personal preference. It may not have any effect on Genshin Impact Mobile. After connecting your controller or gamepad, it will be recognized by BlueStacks and show up as an alternative to your keyboard and mouse. In the Performance tab, you should set these according to your PC's performance. Allocate a high amount of CPU cores if you don't have a lot of other applications running in the background. The same goes for your memory allocation. For users with 4 GB or less RAM, set this option to low. Under Performance mode, make sure to set this option to balanced. This will reduce the memory and CPU usage if your PC lags or you otherwise encounter low performance. I prefer to enable the high FPS option and set the frame rate of the emulator according to my screen refresh rate. If you need more clarification on your refresh rate, right-click your desktop and select Display Settings. From here, make sure that the correct display is selected. Scroll down and click on Advanced Display. This will allow you to preview your refresh rate and change it if you want. Also, if you troubleshoot performance issues, enable the FPS counter option. Set the display orientation to landscape in your display settings and choose a fitting resolution to play Genshin Impact Mobile on your monitor. You can also adjust the size of this window by dragging its corners. You can leave the other settings to the default option and play Genshin Impact Mobile to see how well it runs on your PC. Click on the keyboard icon in your BlueStacks menu bar and enable the on-screen controls option. This lets you preview the default button layout for your keyboard and connected controller. Lower the opacity of this overlay to make it less distracting. Next, head over to your Genshin Impact settings. Adjust your control settings to your liking. Your controller may not appear as a control type option, but BlueStacks will still recognize it and your input will translate over to the game. Adjust your sensitivity settings below, and then navigate to your graphics settings. If you encounter a lag or any other performance-related problems with Genshin Impact, then lower the graphics quality preset of the game. You might also want to lower the render resolution and shadow quality before applying your changes. In the Account section of your settings, you can access the User Center to link your account and continue playing where you left off on your PC or mobile device. After making these changes, you can enjoy Genshin Impact Mobile on your Windows PC or Mac using a controller. These steps and more information will be available in our extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.